Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to start a series on using Microsoft Visio. Now, what is Microsoft Visio? Microsoft Visio is an application created by Microsoft that allows you to create flowcharts, diagrams, schematics, or any other kind of visual representation you would need of maybe a process or an organizational chart or any other pictorial diagram that you may be needing. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So how do you get Microsoft Visio? Well, on Microsoft's website, you can come here and there are two different options for Microsoft Visio. You can have the Plan 1 or Plan 2. And if you notice down here, you can try each for a month, and maybe you want to download a couple of those and try them out and see which one better suits your needs. But once you download Microsoft Visio from the website, and I will include this website in the description below, then you can go to your taskbar down here and just type in Visio. And you will see that application up here and just click on it to launch it. So once you are inside of Microsoft Visio, you have a couple of options. If I go down here to the New tab, I can start a blank drawing, which is what we are going to do today, but I can also look down here and see a whole bunch of different templates. Perhaps there is a template that's already been created for the purposes that you have in mind today. So look through those and save yourself a lot of time. I also want to show you that if you go over here to Open, if you have any recent files that you've worked on, you will see them appearing over here on the right in this list. You can also hit Browse and go through the files that are on your computer. Also, if I go back to the Home button up here, I can see any recent files I have opened, and I can also see the pinned files just like I can in other Microsoft applications. But right now, I'm going to click on Blank Drawing. And I will be asked if I want this to be in metric units or US units. Let's try metric units and say create. So once I'm in Visio, I can see my blank document over here. And by default, the shapes show up over here on the left. And this is really, really helpful because most of what you will be using in Visio are shapes. So if I go to more shapes right here, I can select different categories of shapes. So right now, I'm going to go with General and click on Basic Shapes. And over here on the left, I will see a whole bunch of basic shapes. So if I click on this rectangle over here and drag it into my diagram, I will now have a rectangle on my document. And if I want other shapes on here, I can just click with my left mouse button and drag over here. And let's put on a square and an ellipse. And a triangle. So those are just some basic shapes for our diagram that we're going to work on today. So let's go through each one of the ribbons up here. On the Home ribbon, I have the typical copy and paste, and I can cut shapes. So if I want to cut this triangle and right click over here and go to paste, I can put my triangle in the new spot. Or if I want to move my shapes around, I can just click with my left mouse button and then click again and just drag the shape to wherever I would like it to be on the page. Another thing I can do when I select a shape is you can see these circles all around the shape. I can click and drag either on the corner or I can click and drag on the side. But notice no matter what dot I click and drag from, I'm keeping the aspect ratio consistent. And what I mean by that is I'm not dragging in and turning this square into a rectangle. I'm actually keeping it a square. I'm just making it bigger or smaller based on the direction that I move it in. Okay, so one of the major elements inside of a Visio diagram are the shapes, but there is another element in here that we should go over, and that is called a connector. Now, if I select this shape right here and I go to connector, I can connect this shape to this one. And let me show you how I do that. I'm going to delete that, and on here, I'm going to select connector, And then I'm just going to go to one of these dots, depending on how I want to connect this shape. And I'm going to hold my left mouse button down and drag it to another shape. And you can notice over here on this shape, there's automatic connection points. So if I want to connect this to the center of my circle, I will just hover over that connection point. Or if I want to connect over here on the left, I can just hover over that connection point. So as soon as I let my mouse button go, I have a connector now between these two shapes. So if I were to go up here back to the pointer tool and click on my circle and move it, the connector is now going to move wherever I put that circle on the page. One final thing I can add is a text box. If I click here for text, I can say my circle. And now if I go back to the pointer tool and I select my circle, that text is going to move anywhere on the screen as well as my connector now. I can also click on that text box and change the color of the font right here. Let's say I want that to be purple, and I can make the size of that font a lot bigger. I can make it bold, italicized, underline, whichever you would like. And you can see you have the typical text align as well as other options for text. I can also click on my square right here and go to fill, and I can fill this with any color I would like. So let's say I would like blue for now. I can also have an outline of a different color. Let's say I would like my outline to be in red, and I would also like my outline to be really thick. I can come down here to the weight and make it, say, a 6-point outline. I can also select more than one shape at a time. If I select the square and hold down shift and then select the ellipse down here, if I then go up to align and go to align left, my shapes will now be lined up. I can also go to align top and align bottom or middle or whatever you would like. Also, if I would prefer this shape to be in front, I can select the blue square and I can hit bring to front, or I can hit send to back, and I can reposition my shapes that way. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Now, if I go to the insert menu, there's a couple different things I can insert into my Visio diagram. I can put an image. So let's go here and go to picture. And let's say I want to put my Excel Online logo, make that a lot bigger and drag it down to the left. I can do that. I can also put a border around that if I would like. Let's say I would like a black border. And I can also crop it with the crop tool if I would like to do that. But going back to insert, you can also insert a chart, or you could insert a CAD drawing right here. You can also insert links to places online, as well as some other objects. Now, if I go to the Design tab, I can add some themes to my Visio diagram. So let's say I just select this theme right here. You can see that my shapes all have a certain background color. I have some outline colors, etc. Just play around with the different colors and you can make your Visio diagram look pretty much however you would like. On the design ribbon, I can also go to the orientation of my page and change that to landscape or change it back to portrait. I can also change the size of my paper here to either letter or legal or even a custom size down here if you would like that. I can also go to the view menu and I can zoom into my diagram. Let's say I want 200% and say okay. And I can use my mouse wheel to go around to different parts of my page, or I can also zoom out back to about 50% and say okay. If I have more than one window open, I can arrange my windows, or I can cascade them so I can see more than one Visio diagram at a time. And I can also have a presentation mode where I can just see my different Visio diagrams. This is sort of similar to PowerPoint. And when you're done with presentation mode, you can hit escape and go back to Visio. I can go to the help menu if there's more that I want to find out. But if you've learned about an action you can do inside of Visio and you just can't remember what ribbon that's on, you can always go here and type background And let's say we want to put this one in. I can go back to the file menu and I have some options here. I can go to save. And if I hit browse, I just want to show you these different options of what you have for file types. I can save this as a VSDX Visio drawing file, but I also wanted to show you that you can save this as an AutoCAD drawing, just a JPEG, or a PDF as well. And also, one more thing to let you know when you're saving. If I cancel out of here and I go back, if I highlight just part of my diagram and I go to File, Save, and go back to Browse, let's say I save that as just a JPEG and save it on my desktop, and I go back out here, I've only saved part of my diagram because that's what I selected before I hit the Save button. Also on the File menu, I can share this either by OneDrive or through email. I can open other files, and I can go to a new file, and I can also just close this existing file, just like I can in most other Microsoft applications. So hopefully that's a quick overview of some of the options you have available to you in Microsoft Visio. We'll be doing a few more videos on this, so if you have more specific things that you would like to do in Visio, keep looking for those in the coming weeks. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.